This is probably the first ever raise in the Philippines na nilift. So first mover. What is up, guys? Welcome back to another vlog. We are here in Goodyear Servitech dito sa may auto camp because we're about to do something crazy to the car. If you watch our previous vlogs, yung nag-offroad tayo with Project Raize. Sayad ng sayad yung Raize sa mga light trail. And we got inspired to build Project Raize to become like an overland kind of build. Hindi naman yung sobrang wild na pang-offroad. Pang-overland lang. Let's go! So yun na, guys. Nakasalang na dito yung car. And ito yung springs na gagamitin natin. So ito yung Tanabe Sustec na UP210. So as you can see, yung springs is red and mahaba siya. So before they start the install on this thing, hindi ko pa pala napapakita sa inyo, guys, but we actually have a new Cusco strut bar installed over here, and yung blue na protective film niyan dito pa, hindi siya talaga blue, stainless steel na finish talaga siya, pero yan, nakamount na siya dito. Hindi ko na napakita last time because we did it after finishing one of the vlogs. And then we put a Cusco sticker over here para lang, wala, para lang mas maganda. If you ask me, may effect ba yung strut bar sa overall handling ng car? I could say meron, because when you drive the car with the strut bar on, iba yung feeling. Parang less yung body roll sa harap, more rigid feeling. So if you wanna get better feel from the front end of your car, I'd actually highly recommend that you get a strut bar na ganito. Suspension ng Toyota Raize sa harap. It's just a regular McPherson strut. So meaning, it's just this one. Ito yung parang tinatawag mong coilover. Yan yung spring. Ito yung shock. And then, may lower control arms lang sa ilalim. And then, ito yung mga camber bolts. So what we're gonna do today is papalitan natin yung spring. So tatanggalin tong shock. Palit yung spring. Balik yung shock. And then, yung camber bolt. Papalitan natin yung isa dyan para ma-align natin ng maayos yung kung paano nakahiga yung wheel. Yung likod naman, guys, is a divorced spring and shock combo. So torsion beam kasi yung likod, di na kailangan tanggalin yung shock. Usually they just loosen it sa baba. Itong nakita niyo to. Yan. Usually they just loosen that. Alignment sa rear hindi nagagalaw because torsion beam lang to. Natanggal na ni Kuya yung bolt and nut dito. And ito yung spring. Hindi niya matanggal eh. Hindi niya matanggal even if naka-disconnect na to. So what he's doing, pati yung kabila, tinatanggal niya so that the whole torsion beam bababa. Natanggal na ni Kuya yung bolt and nut for both sides, so bumagsak na yung buong torsion beam. Ayan, natanggal na niya yung spring. That's how the rear suspension works for the Toyota Raize. Stock spring. Tanabe Sustec na UP10. So sa kabila, that's what he's also doing. Sok naman, no, Kuya? Pasok naman. Okay. So guys, tapos na yung sa likod. So, yan yung itsura niya. And as you can see, parang mas lifted na nga siya ng konti. So, tingnan natin yung itsura mamaya pag nakabit na lahat. So, here it is, guys. Nakakabit na. And if you guys can notice it, iba na yung bolt natin sa taas versus sa baba. Kasi itong bolt, this is what we use to adjust the camber, yung higa ng wheel. So, pinalitan na natin to. Kasi when you lift your suspension, gagalaw yung suspension arm sa ilalim, which affects the camber, which is why pag maglilift ka, kailangan mo na itong camber bolt to adjust the camber back to the normal settings. So to you viewers out there, baka meron palang gustong bumili nito, used for only 800 kilometers, so baka gusto niya nang bilhin to full set, just send me a DM on Instagram. What are you doing here? Huh? Yeah, malaki yung tinaas, oh. What is up, guys? We are finally home and Project Raize is back in the garage. And now, it's actually lifted. So let me show you what it looks like. So here is Project Raize, and what we've specifically done is that we've lifted the car using the Tanabe Sustec UP210 lift springs. So over here at the front, we lifted it up by 31 millimeters. And over here at the back, we lifted it up by 28 millimeters. So in inches, that's a 1.2-inch lift sa harap and 1.1-inch lift sa likod. The only problem that we have right now is that nafe-feel ko na the stabilizer link dito, yung parang
stick na yan. I can feel it binding. And how do you know if it's binding? Basically, pag bumababa ka ng hump, you feel like the front wheels want to crash down. You know? Did you guys hear that? So, bakit nangyari yun? It's because we lifted the car, pero yung stabilizer link fixed yung length niyan eh. And that's what's causing it to do that. So, ang kailangan natin gawin is to change the stabilizer link to an adjustable one para ma-extend natin siya. Basically, relaxed siya in a neutral position.
So that was our first time there in Goodyear Servitech sa my auto camp. And in terms of experience naman, I would rate my customer experience there 7.5 to 8 out of 10 because na-install naman nila ng tama lahat. And they did a good job. Mabilis sila kausap. It's just that one, they didn't have a torque wrench. So I had to provide that para ma-torque yung mga bolts and nuts ng maayos so that we prevent from over-torquing. And second, pina-align yung car of course, pero I came home with a crooked alignment, meaning yung steering wheel ko, although I was driving straight, yung steering wheel ko nakatabing ito to the right. So kailangan ko pang bumalik sa kanila just to have that fixed. But maliit lang naman na bagay, but that's why I gave them a 7.5 to 8 out of 10. So ayun. Would I recommend them? I think I would kasi okay naman sila. It's just that may mga little things na kailangan pang tutukan. So here guys is a better angle of the car na naka-lift na. And if I zoom in, you can see na malaki na yung wheel gap dito. Tsaka dito sa harap. So in terms of ride comfort, hindi muna ako magko-comment kasi nga naka-bind pa yung stabilizer link sa harap. So I'll do a review siguro of the ride comfort next time. So it says here, Cusco, made in Japan. Yeah. So anyway guys, that's it for this vlog. This is probably the first ever Raize in the Philippines na nilift. Since nilift na natin, there are many things that are coming for Project Raize. And if you guys enjoyed this video, I hope you could leave a like and subscribe to my channel for future Raize content. So that's it for this vlog guys. I'll see you guys next time. You guys take care. Goodbye.